Today I'm going to talk about the global settings tab on the Valeton GP200 software. If you've ever been confused by all the sliders, the toggles and the drop downs in this section, I understand you. I'll walk you through each setting so you can fully customize your GP200 for your needs. Just a little disclaimer, this is gonna be quite technical, so hang with me. First we have the input-output settings. Now I can show you between all the toggles, the EGT, the AGT and the line. We have here the EGT just for electric guitars. You can optimize for electric guitars, this one. This one is for acoustic guitars, that's why the A is. So, and line. With line you can just perfect for external devices like keyboards or drum machines. You can even use your voice. You can connect a microphone, for example. Now I'm gonna pick up my electric guitar and test the three modes with it. So I hope this quick test just demonstrates how they sound, the three modes. My preferred one is the electric guitar, the one made for the electric guitar. If you have some thoughts about what you heard, please just leave in the comments. So after the three modes, you have the input level. Let's talk about it. This slider adjusts the input gain, allowing you to fine-tune the signal before it hits the effects chain. So you can set it to zero just for a neutral level or increase it. Yeah, you can raise the gain up for a better noise floor ratios, but just avoid clipping. On the cab mode, you have the left and the right. This toggle allows you to disable cabinet simulation for the left or right output channels. Just for example, if you're connecting this to a real amp or an external cab simulator, turn this on to bypass GP200 cab simulation. Like this. You can use the both. For example, if you want to send the signal, the left signal, to your amp, you need to toggle this on because you don't want to send IR to your real amp, to your real cab. And if you want to send at the same time from the right channel to the front house, you can. You just toggle this off and you're using the IR of the Valeton GP200 to send it to the front house. So this is a huge advantage. Let's talk about the USB audio interface. This is just crucial for anyone who wants to record through the Valeton GP200 or just use it as an audio interface. So you have the rec level. I usually have set it to zero. So this slider just sets the output volume for USB audio. So you can keep it around zero just for handle the signal. But if you notice a clipping in your recordings, you can lower the setting slightly just so it doesn't clip. For the rec mode, you have the left and the right channel. Usually I have just the left channel connected because I'm using mono and mono is on the left. But if you want to use the both, you can. For example, the wet just means that the outputs process signal with effects. And if you want to choose the dry one, it just means that the output is clean if you want to use with no effects. A great feature for recording both in a polished tone and a clean DI track for reamping later. So, if you want to record to your DAW, you can just put the wet signal to the left and the dry to the right. Then in Ozo you can just connect it to a different tracks and you can make a reamp for the other one. You can just put whatever amp you want on the dry signal. So you can keep a DI track and a wet track with effects of the Valeton. If you want to know more about double tracking and reamping, you can check this video right here. The auxiliary to USB. If it's on, this toggle just lets you route the auxiliary input signal just like a backing track or audio from your phone to the USB output. So you can just connect some audio, external audio here, connect it directly to your computer, and you can do a backing track, for example. This one adjusts the playback volume for USB monitoring. This one is useful just for balancing your live playing with your computer playback. Okay, so now let's talk about the AutoCab match feature. I usually have it on because I don't want to be just concerned about do I have the right cab or not for my amp. This feature automatically syncs your cabinet settings with your amp module, so it's a huge lifesaver. Unless you want to experiment trying your amp with different cabs, so you can. You just toggle it off and you can do your experiments. Finally, we have the device display settings, which lets you control how the GP200 presents information on screen on the multi-effects pedal. So you have the foot switch one, where you can see all the switches on the screen. You have the patch one, and the patch you can just see whatever you're using, just in text. And the one that I prefer the most is the signal chain, because I can see all my pedals, all my effects, so it helps me to go faster. So you can just switch between these modes depending on your preferences. Personally, I just prefer to use all the chain visible, so I can see whatever the effect is on or off. If you want to know more about the Valeton GP200, I have some other videos on my channel that you can check right here. And if you want to know more about the global settings software, the other settings that I didn't talk about, let me know in the comments. I will be happy to make another video about this. And please like, subscribe, and hope to see you in the next one.